Hey Pisces, how are you? First and foremost, happy birthday for those Pisces whose birthday is in March. This is kind of an amazing time for you guys. I mean, there's a lot going on besides that the sun is in Pisces, Mercury will be retrograde the 5th, which is very close to when I'm doing this video. And it will be retrograde almost for the entire month. Very interesting time. Besides that, Venus is also going into Pisces. There's just a lot going on. So, what I think that you guys are dealing with is I think, first and foremost, you guys are dealing with an individual that is not happy, okay? Almost like a father figure or somebody that has, kind of a high stance in their community or just a structured individual, could be like an Aries type. He's not happy, okay? And I think he's not happy because there's no new beginning with you guys. Maybe this individual is looking to have a new beginning, and Pisces, it seems like you're thinking it over and you're like, no, that's not for me, okay? And to confirm that, it's because you are cutting things out, with this Queen of Swords, which has this individual, in a state of not knowing what to do, okay? And so the best thing that you can do, Pisces, at this moment is, the Five of Wands in reverse. So kind of just worry about yourself, let things go, kind of just, let bygones be bygones. Let's agree to disagree. In the past, you have the Moon reverse, so there was, some confusion, and we have the Patience card, to clarify that. So maybe, this confusion was asking you to have patience in the situation, to see what's further to come. Hidden factors around you, Nine of Swords. Okay, so someone, and I assume it's this High Priest in reverse, is kind of going through it. I think they're really stressing about some things, okay? And they could be stressing because in your next move, Pisces, you have the Two of Cups. So, and to clarify that, okay, to clarify that, you have the Three of Swords, okay, with the Two of Pentacles reversed for with the Six of Wands, and that was kind of all that. Like the Six of Wands was walking away from this, Pisces. So I think that you have a new beginning. There's this new connection with someone, and you're walking away from this heartbreak and this indecision and not being able to juggle, feeling overwhelmed, and you're kind of just like, okay, you know what? I'm gonna go have victory elsewhere, okay? And I think that this is what this person is stressed about, okay? So you're over here walking away from that while they are still in contemplation and not having closure, okay? The world reversed. Now they're juggling and they don't have closure now that they're stressed out and in their head. And in Pisces, I know to get you to move on, you're a very patient and caring person. So to get you to move on is they might have had, they put you through the ringer, okay? So again, how you see yourself, the Eight of Cups, so you're moving on. How people see you is the Nine of Cups. So you're moving on and you're doing your thing by yourself. You are self-fulfilled. You got it going on. You're making yourself happy. You know that this is what's best for you. You're abundant all by yourself, okay? And you're hoping to, just maintain that stability. And so the outcome is very interesting because you have the Four of Cups. So kind of a discontent, if you see this card, kind of this fairy or this angel, this guide is giving this little boy the cup, and he's kind of like, no, I don't want it. I just don't want it. Yeah. So to clarify that, all right, we have the Queen of Cups with the Sun and the Tower. So what I'm getting from this is, yeah, you're discontent with the situation, and you are the Queen of Cups, okay? You're in your power. You're this Nine of Cups here in your power, this Queen, okay? And you're moving towards this Sun, whether it means that you have to shake some things up and change some things around, okay? And to clarify that, we got Storm Warning, which makes perfect sense with the Tower, and then the Thinking Woman. So, you are thinking things over and you're standing your ground, Pisces, which I love. This energy, I think Mars was also in Pisces, this energy of you. Pisces is this very, empathetic and very soft and sensual and sensitive. And it doesn't mean you don't have other sides of you, but this side of you that's coming out right now, this strong side of you that is cutting cutting these things, cutting the BS that doesn't serve you away. I love that, Pisces. The only thing that I could really just say of caution is the Queen of Swords. Yes, she cut things away, but she can also cut someone's head off at that. So just be very careful. You know, I know you have this roar and this push forward, but just be very careful to think before you speak. You know, you don't want to feel bad later about overdoing it. So definitely, I'm so happy that we're cutting things off. I mean, I'm a fellow Pisces as well. Storm warning, storm is coming, but I'm not worried about it because you're in total control. Okay, guys. So that was your reading for April. I'm sorry, my dog is kind of going a little crazy here on the carpet. So I hope you guys have a fantastic rest of April. And this reading can go anywhere up to mid-year. The energies are timeless. So whenever you watch this reading, this could also resonate. Leave a comment. Let me know if it resonated with you or not. And I'll see you guys soon. Take care. Bye.